Hey, what's up guys, Paulo Munoz here. This is gonna be a very quick video. I just got a few questions about this device right here, which is the SpaceMouse PRO wireless from 3D Connection. And this is something that I use on a day-to-day basis to rotate and manipulate the 3D space in 3D applications and rotate around the model. It just makes it really, really simple and very intuitive using this dial to essentially move in all axes at the same time. So it is a great tool, but this video is not about this thing specifically, but rather about the SpaceMouse wireless Bluetooth. So this one is a much more compact and simpler device, but it has all the functionality of this Pro version. So I just wanted to show you this one because it's a lot cheaper and it has exactly the same capability. It is also manufactured by 3D Connection, so you know everything is the same. So I'm just gonna go ahead and switch here so you can see what I'm doing. All right, so this is the SpaceMouse Wireless Bluetooth Edition. You can just go to this website from 3D Connection and read more about it. And this one right here is the SpaceMouse PRO Wireless, which I use all the time. Now, I'm not right-handed, so I use this one on my left-hand side because this is not a replacement for your mouse. I actually have a very cool mouse that I use on my right-hand side, but this one allows me to manipulate the space. So I use this as a kind of like a replacement of my keyboard because I can manipulate and move everything with this dial right here. And eventually, if I need to, I can map, you know, different commands or shortcuts to the different buttons. I don't use the buttons as much. The real magic of this mouse is in the dial right here. So that's what I wanted to show you, the smaller version, which is this one right here. All right, so it comes with a really nice carry case. I'm just gonna go ahead and open it and show you that it is exactly the same thing in a much more compact version. Right, it feels heavy, and you know the build quality is fantastic. It's actually a lot heavier than the Pro version, which is funny. But you know it feels like a premium device, right? So it is really, really simple. All it has is the dial. It has the charging USB-C. You can turn it on from here, and it has a couple of buttons that you can actually map to different applications. So what I'm gonna do is I wanna set it up here. And I'll show you how this works in, you know, in practical terms with other applications. So let's go ahead and turn it on. And you'll see that blue light coming from underneath the dial that is basically telling you that it is connected. And I'm going to switch to ZBrush, which is one of the applications that I use the most. And here we go. This is ZBrush. And I've just been playing around with this device. But if I go ahead and hold this dial, you'll see that I can rotate. I'm actually twisting or tilting this device, and as I do that, you see how I can rotate the object. Now, it is a little bit tricky to get used to it, but once you understand how this works, it's very, very intuitive. It's literally like having the object on your hand, and you can manipulate it as you would like any 3D object in real life. So basically, if I take this dial and I push it this way, so you don't have to tilt it or rotate it, you can just take the whole thing and push it forward. So if I just do this, you'll see how I push the device away, and I can pull it towards me, and that's basically your zoom in and out. So you don't have to rotate it. If you rotate it, it's actually going to, you know, rotate the device in that direction. You can do the same thing on the other side, so you can just do it like that, right? Or you can do it like this, and that will rotate in this axis. So you have all the axes at the same time, so if I can do all of this, you see, it just goes a little bit crazy. But again, once you get familiar with how it works, it is very intuitive. Now, if you want to pan up and down or left and right, all you have to do is take the dial and push it to the right or to the left or up towards the, in this case, towards the camera, or push it down. And that's the simplest way to put it. All right, so I can just, you know, push this down, push it up, right, left, push it away from me, push it towards me, and that's how you can manipulate this this object. Now, again, once you get familiar with this, you don't have to remember all the, you know, the different configurations that I just show you. It just becomes very intuitive. So if I want to manipulate something like the antenna here in this sci-fi device, all I'm going to do is just get closer, and you see it becomes very intuitive, right? So that's why I use it, and that's the reason why I would recommend it, because it makes it very, very easy to navigate the 3D space. Even if you're sculpting, if you're actually using to sculpt, I'm gonna switch to my Wacom now, and if I go closer here, I can just go ahead and start, you know, pressing and maybe adding a little bit of damage. And as I move things around, this is a pretty dense mesh, by the way, so it's a little bit sluggish. But you know, as I go ahead and start adding these details or these wear and tear to the object, all I have to do is use my pen to obviously sculpt the details. But I use this little device to manipulate and rotate things around, and I think it just makes it a lot of fun. It's very, very easy. Of course, you know, you can still do the normal navigation with the alt key, in this case with ZBrush. But one of the things that I found it to be incredibly useful is that this navigation, this, once you get used to how this device works, it works across multiple applications, right? So let's say that I'm happy with the modeling of this. I would just go ahead and export it to add the textures inside Substance Painter. So let's bring in Substance Painter right here. And there we go. So I can do exactly the same thing that I was doing in ZBrush, but in Substance Painter, right? So I can rotate things in the same way. I can zoom in and out. So here are the textures. Let me actually go in full screen so it's a bit better. So yeah, the navigation is exactly the same. I think this is one of the best things about this device that allows you to manipulate the, you know, the 3D space in the same way across multiple applications. Again, once you get comfortable with the navigation, you can just get closer here. And I'm just going to start adding some damage, some scratches. And as I rotate things around, you know, it allows me to explore these, you know, the details of this device a little bit better, right? Now, another really cool thing, and this is something I mentioned just at the beginning, is that you can actually map these two buttons that you have on the left and on the right to different things depending on the software. So it actually recognizes the application, so it has context. In this case, it knows that I'm in 3D Painter. So if I press this one, for example, and I right-click, as I sculpt, or as I, not a sculpt, but add details, I can hold the right button right here and right click on my mouse, and this allows me to rotate my my environment. So that's pretty handy because I can just check that the lighting and everything is working fine as I sculpt, and I can rotate things around, then rotate the light again. So again, it becomes very intuitive. Obviously, you can assign this to anything you want. Another thing that I quite like that I use for this specific software is the solo mode, right? Or the focus mode, as it's called in Substance 3D Painter. So if I click on this one right here, it's going to isolate the object, and that way I can, you know, maybe add, let's actually rotate the environment, add some scratches here, and I can just manipulate only this object. And when I want to see the entire object, I can press the other, and there we go, right? So again, all of these things, all of these extra things that I'm giving you is because you can map anything that you want to these two, to these buttons, in the same way that with the big one, you can do it with any of these buttons. So with the Pro one, you can do it with multiple buttons, and that gives you, you know, access to more tools if you wanted to. But in all honesty, this is all you need. The navigation is the core of this device, right? So now let's say if I finish with the, you know, with the textures, I just do a quick check and make sure that everything looks fine. I can go ahead and export this and set it up in something like a Blender, which will be, in this case, my rendering tool. Now, Blender works exactly the same thing. So you have exactly the same navigation that I had in ZBrush and in 3D Painter, but in Blender. So I can get closer, check all my stuff in here. I'm going to go ahead and enter in rendering mode. This is cycles, so it might be a little bit slow. That's all right. There we go. So now I can check all the details that I set up for my, you know, for the screen, all the extra details that I did for my texturing, and I can review things in a lot of detail. Now, in my case, what I've done is I mapped the right button to be the shift key on Blender, and this one on the left-hand side is just the frame. So, for example, if I'm just like working and rotating things around, and for some reason, I just move away maybe too far, all I need to do is press this button right here, and it will just frame it, right? And this is just mapped to my dot key in my number pad. And then the shift key is just so that I can do very subtle panning. So let's say if I get closer and I'm just, I don't know, checking this area right here, I can press the shift button, and then on my other hand, so with my mouse, I can pan things like so. So it's very, very, very subtle. I can do the same thing just by doing this, right? But sometimes I just want to get very close to check something. Sometimes maybe I'm just moving a vertex or something like that, and I will just use this button right here. Like I said, you can map these two things for absolutely anything that you want. And in fact, you can create a combo of multiple shortcuts. So I'll show you that in just a second at the end of this video. One more thing that I want to show you, because I think it is fantastic, is PureRef. So PureRef is the application that I use to collect references. So these are some of the references that I collected when I was, you know, building this sci-fi gadget. And it is fantastic. And they have implemented with the new version and the support for this device right here. So I'm just going to show you how smooth zooming in and out of the references is. Again, if I just pull the entire thing towards, in this case, towards the camera, it's going to pan up. If I push it down, is going to go down, and left and right, that's the panning. So again, once you get used to the simple sort of like movements of this dial, you'll see it's very, very intuitive. So you can just very quickly move through the different resources. And it's, yeah, and as I keep saying, one of the biggest things for me is that I can use exactly the same navigation across multiple devices. All right, so that's about it in terms of what this device is. Again, very simple, but very powerful stuff. And I'm just going to show you how you can map these things. All right, so I'm just going to switch back to ZBrush, for example. And once you install the drivers, you'll have this this application right here. So you'll see if I click on this SpaceMouse Wireless, I would have my Bluetooth Tiny version and the Pro version. I also have a keyboard and a Numpad Pro as well from 3D Connection, which is pretty handy. But anyway, we're talking about this one. So make sure that you have that one selected if you have any other devices that are from 3D Connection. And then you'll see that here at the top, it recognizes that I'm in ZBrush. If it doesn't, you can just click on ZBrush and then Alt-Tab to go back to this, and it will recognize it. The only thing that I'm going to show you is that you can click on buttons, right? And it comes up with this other window. Let's put it here at the top. And in this window, you can put anything you want on the left and on the right buttons, right? So on the left-hand side, I put Alt-Q, and on the right, I put Alt-A. So these are my custom shortcuts for my custom palettes, right? So if I go into ZBrush and I press the right-hand side, it brings all my, you know, all the tools that I use constantly, like my brushes. I can edit my brushes, and I can create brushes as well. So this is a custom palette. It has nothing to do with the with 3D Connection device. It's more about the UI in ZBrush. The right-hand side gives me access to other tools that I use constantly, so I can inflate the object, right, as you can see there, and that sort of stuff. So you can map it to absolutely anything you want, and I'm just going to show you how you can change it for the sake of demo. So if I go back to this thing, right, I'm going to use the right button to go into solo mode. So for me in ZBrush, the solo mode is the S key, so I'm going to press S just to add it in there, and that's it. Now I'm going to go back to ZBrush. I'm going to start working, let's say, continue the sculpting process of this damage here. And if I want to go in solo mode, I just press the right button, and now I'm in solo mode. Pretty much the same thing that I have on my 3D painted to go into focus mode or solo mode, right? So you can totally do that, and you see it's very, very easy. Just select whatever you want. Now, the other thing that I was talking about in terms of adding more shortcuts within those two single buttons is to create a radial menu. So for instance, instead of using the S, I want to click on this icon right here, and I'm going to search for these radial menus. So I'm going to click on this arrow, and I'm going to click on new radial menu, and there we go. So this one is fantastic. It is similar to the Wacom radial menus, if you're familiar with that. You can add your own custom icon and all of that. So I'm going to click and give it a name, My Tools, right? And this time I'm going to leave it at 4, but you can have, you know, 8 sections if you wanted to. But let's keep it simple. I'm going to go for 8, and I can just go ahead and map those 4 things in here. So I'm going to go solo mode for 1. I'm going to go F to frame, maybe, with number 2. For number 3, I'm going to press Q, which is going to bring my my gizmo. And for number 4, maybe I can use Shift D, which is going to change my subdivision level. So let's go ahead and click on Save. Right, and now the right button of my device is going to bring this custom set of tools. So now when I'm working in ZBrush, I can press this button and it bring my radial menu, which is really nice. And you don't need to click anywhere, you just need to move your mouse towards the command. So for example, let me do it again. I have S, so I just go up. I don't click on anything, I just go up. So again, button, up, solo, button, up, right? That is fantastic. Now the other one that I have is Shift D. Right, so I just go down in my subdivision level. Let me get closer here so that you can see what I'm doing. So just going down in subdivision level, right? I could potentially do the same thing just so it's more practical to go up as well, but I just wanted to show you how it works. Another thing is Q, which is going to bring in the gizmo. So if I'm in this mode, I can just press Q and I'll go out of the gizmo. Now, the other one that I set up is frame. So if I just get out of frame, frame the object, get out of solo mode. So you see, it becomes very intuitive when you get used to, and because you can customize it absolutely in any way you want, it will be basically something that that truly works and that truly benefits your own workflow. All right, and as a final note, I've been with this device for about 2 weeks and a half now, and I only charged it once since I got it. So the battery life is pretty good, and I've been using it daily, you know, as a replacement of the Pro version, which again, the whole idea or the whole purpose was to try to prove that true value of these type of gadgets are the navigation, which is in the dial, not necessarily on the buttons. All right, so I'm going to leave this video here. Let me know if you find it useful, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.